Talk Show. We're up here at Lou Castle's on Spring Hill and Mobile Street in between Crunch Town Club and Fill It Up Gas Station. This is her specialty. I wanted to show you her baked potato. This is her specialty. Isn't that nice, ladies and gentlemen? What we got on here, young man?
Oh, we got pulled pork, sour cream, cheese, bacon bits.
Pulled pork, sour cream, cheese, what, bacon bits.
Ain't got your baked potato in the bottom, you know what I'm saying? That's the top.
And she butter all that. She that out and dress it before she put it back in, then top it.
Then top.
She told them she'd dress it. Now, this here is a meal. And that's Jazz Red Meal. Jazz taking that to the shipyard, baby. So we're going to talk with the CEO's sons here. I call him Chef Boyon. Chef Boyon. Jazz Red. Peace out. Jazz Red Talk Show. See, now, let me let you know who this is. This is Lou Castle's husband there. That is the right-hand man, the cream and coffee man, and whatever. And know something, the gopher, because he may have to go
that's
to
right.
the bank
I
or go pick up
I
something.
I don't know how to cook, so I'm the gopher.
You the gopher, that's right. Yeah. Gopher. He'll bring you a napkin and whatever. So
A paper towel.
What help you... I want to know what inspired you to come up and help your wife with this business.
She did. She always wanted to open a restaurant. She always loved to cook, so she said, she passed by the place, she said, I want to open that restaurant right there.
No, she did.
Yes, she did.
So she never told me that.
So I said, hey, go for it. I said, you've been wanting to do it for a long time, so here's your time.
And you were 100% behind?
Had to be.
Now I'm just wondering how you know.
Now you know, baby. Now you know why.
I know you, but I wanted my viewers to know that. I mean, you're a good person. I only been knowing you all a few months. I come up and met your son, and it's just like we family.
That's right.
It's just like we family.
And that's how it is with her, she and I.
And that's what it is with her customers. I've seen your wife deal with her customers and love them to death, talk to them. It's like she's a counselor up here and everything.
That's right.
I mean, I've seen that.
And that's the personality.
That it really is. She got a great personality.
Good personality.
And she loves to cook. She loves people.
She loves to meet people, and she loves to cook.
She sure do.
That's two pluses for her, Jay.
That's right. Woman of God. Now, you do know your wife donated $1 to every order.
I ain't getting you a dime.
To that. Hey, look. You want me to whoop you, man?
I ain't getting you a dime.
You want me to whoop you?
Yes, sir.
Me and him, we always joke like this, but I'm going to get him. Yes. Your wife is giving $1 on every order to keep that lady's home. We're trying to keep a lady's home.
Oh, didn't
she didn't tell you. You be working and be busy. That's why he said that he didn't know. Yeah, this lady's about to lose her house for $1,500.
Okay.
And that'll pay it off.
That's good.
So we are up here at Lou Castle, and Lou Castle give $1 on every order she has.
That's okay.
Yeah, and the Davis Avenue book, hardback edition. Y'all are meeting her a little later on in the show because me and her going out of town. We're going to Central Neal. $10 off of that book going to go toward the lady house. So everybody been on board. I want to thank Mike that work at McDonald's. Mike told me to come up and pick up some money. I'm on my way, Mike. Mr. and Mrs. Price out of Mississippi. A little young couple, they heard about what I was doing, and they sent $20 in that letter that you read.
Okay, that was a nice letter.
Yeah, she wrote me a letter. She's a blessed lady. Everybody's getting on board to help this lady keep this house. So you all, please, don't forget to stop by Lou Castle. She's the point of contact. Her and her hubby here, they're going to be collecting the money because I work and I can't be out, but look, I got a bag-up generator here.
There you go.
They my bag-up generator.
We'll take care of it.
I appreciate you all getting on bandwagon with this.
That's good. That's
I really appreciate it.
It's my first year about it, but that's a good thing.
That's a good thing. Your wife is a person you can tell your innermost secrets to. She gonna hold it. That's just it. We gonna do it, man. Before I get, you know, it's always a problem with a man on my show. We gonna get their son, and we'll do a peace out on with Chef Boyon. Tell my viewers, God bless. Wait a minute, did you tell your name?
My name is Dedrick Frank.
Okay, and you've been
I'm
like a
Sunday's husband.
And you've been a businessman yourself, right?
I run a debit truck. 16 years.
16 years.
16 years.
Yeah, dog. And you're still working.
Yeah.
And I'm here in Lou Castle talking to a customer. That's all she do is talk. Me too though.
Yeah.
She's friendly. Tell my viewers, God bless you.
God bless you.
All right, and pray
God
for us.
God bless you too, Jack.
All right, I'm finna bless you when we get off this camera. Jazzy Red Pizza. Here go a happy customer there. All right, we see you, girl. God bless you. Jazzy Red Talk Show, and we're back with the Chef Boyon.
Yeah.
This man can cook him. Chef Boyon. Your daddy called me greedy, man. Got you, you know, one more time, man. One more time, I'm going to get him.
That's him.
I know it. Tell my viewers about your slush. You know, you sell slushes.
Yes. We do sell slushes. With any flavor you can name it, some you ain't probably ain't heard of. We've got our own specialty kind of slushes. We mix it with pine. We mix them together like pineapple, sour apple. You know what I'm saying?
Pineapple, sour apple.
Yeah, we mix them together. But, you know, then we got slushes, snow cones, you know, anything to beat the heat.
Show me ice cream.
Yeah, beat the heat.
I just seen the bluebell, man. Yeah, you get your ice cream cone, man. Milkshakes.
Yeah, you know it's getting hot out here.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
Snow cone.
Yeah.
Snow cone. She sells snow cone.
Still snow cone. Slushes.
I don't think of nothing she don't sell, man. I mean, everything I could ask her for, she said, I got it, Jazz. Come on.
Yeah,
that peach cobbler was off the chain. And the crust was cooked and flaked. I got to tell her about that, too. It was so so good. Right. You know, sometimes you get peach cobbler and it be kind of soggy. Like.
Yeah,
but
right.
It wasn't. I like that. Now, tell them your location.
We're 2701 Spring Hill Avenue, right between Crunch Time and Fill Up Gas Station. You know, come on down and see us.
Give us a phone number for Lou Cap.
It's 404-5851.
And that's a 251. Give it to us one more time.
251-404-5851.
All right, and Jazz Red gonna take her baked potato, head it to the shipyard. Tell them God bless.
All right, now, we see y'all later. Come down to Lou Cap to see us.
All right, you do deliveries too for my sick and my shed in.
Yeah, you do 6-7 more orders. Yeah, we'll deliver them to you.
And you know something? Your dad took one to a hospital for someone to help them. You know, the family was in there and they wanted something to eat. I just want to appreciate that. I also got a buddy in the hospital. I want to say hello to Babyface. How you doing, Babyface? We're going to call you and your sister and your mom. How's your mom? I just love all of you all, okay? And Miss Mary Brown, how you doing, girl? I ain't forgot you. All right, Jazzy Red. Dursey Arlington, hello. All right, Jazzy Red. Peace out. You going to a graduation today. What's your son's name?
My son's name is Jason Cox.
How old is he?
12.
12. Jason Cox graduating from the 5th grade. I ain't had none of my seniors come out yet. Y'all better get me so I can put their picture on it. Jazzy Red, peace out.
Jazzy Red, talk show. You're a master right here. Now put your hand down if you're the master button. You master?
Yeah.
Okay. We got somebody helping with the camera, but she got a hand up there like I'm saying. If you don't turn the camera on. I'm Jazzy Red. I'm Jazzy Red Talk Show for my new viewer. And this is Miss Paulette Hart. We're here in Centronelle. Welcome to Centronelle. Centronelle 1811. Can you tell my viewers a little something about Centronelle right quick?
Yes, Centronelle, as you said, was stated, started in 1811. And former slaves lived here. And it's named after a Centronella plant. And the reason that we're in Centronelle today is because we're trying to save Rosa A. Locke School. It was started by an educator, Rosa A. Locke, and we're going to a ceremony today.
Yeah, and we finna film it because y'all going with it. Jazzy Red, we love peace.
Jazzy Red Talk Show, and we're here at the facility and the festivities. I just want y'all to feel it. We're trying to keep this school open. Rosa A. Locke, Jazzy Red. Peace out. We love you. Jazzy Red Talk Show, and I wanted to bring you out here to see what we're doing. They're trying to keep this school open. I want you all to pray before this program. Y'all pray that they keep this school open. They're all coming out now. This is what it's about, for people to get up when it's something you believe in. Even the young people look at it. When it's something you believe in, you have to stand for something, okay? When you believe that something needed space and it's a landmark, and this is why everybody's out here. All right, Jazzy Red.
Thank you already.
Let's do it again for him.
Look right here. Look
if y'all don't know nobody else, y'all know that lady right there, Mysterio Lovegood. That she is. Come all the way from Mobile up here. All right, if y'all don't know nobody, if you don't see a familiar face, you sure know Cecilia Lovegood. Y'all remember this lady here? She was on my show. Okay. And here she is. Now here's the secretary.
One time, y'all.
We're going to the secretary. Y'all remember her? Remember her coming to my house. And there they are, all in a nutshell, trying to keep this school open. Let's look at this check here. Let's see.
This way.
Golf Coast. R.C.&D. Council.
One more time, this way, y'all.
Rose Lane Hay Lot.
One more time,
look at that.
Look at that,
$5,500. 5th, 18th, 2013. All right, Jazzy Red.
Let us pray. Eternal God, our Father, we bow before your presence, thanking you for this day. Thank you for this gathering and the purpose that we are gathered here today. We pray your blessings upon this day, and even each person that has worked to make this day possible. We ask, Father, that not only will you bless us presently, but even in the future, in every endeavor to make sure that the name and the school of Rosalind lives on. We thank you for all of the contributions that have been made, but most importantly, we thank you for the spirit of love and community that have been shown through these who have gathered here on this day. We simply ask now that each person that will come and even this program would be blessed. And we ask it all today in the name of Christ Jesus. And everybody said together, amen.
Amen.
In Alabama, whose sole mission is to documentation, preservation, and promotion of historic African American places. We advocate for these places. We work to educate ourselves and others about the places like this, which are so important to our collective history. Once we know the history, we work to preserve the buildings and promote the history. Because once a structure is destroyed, a landscape is altered, or an artifact lost, the history is forgotten. In communities throughout the state of Alabama, we are losing our history in this manner. Even more so in African American communities. These places matter. We are here today because you all have made this place matter. Just imagine if Rosa Locke School was not here. This history would be forgotten by the community and even by some of you who attended the school eventually. Preserving the building ensures it remains a part of this community and a part of your historical makeup of this state. So I stand with you today saying, this place matters to all of us, and this historical marker will make it matter to all who visit this area. Thank you.
Y'all ready?
Yeah, we ready.
On three, folks. One, two, three.
Oh, yeah.
There she is, ladies and gentlemen. John Bell and the Rosary Lot. Look at that.
Rosary Lot, Spring School.
Yeah, thank you.
Rosa A. Lot School. This school, constructed as the Citronelle Consolidated School in circa 1949, is significant as the only school for black children in the Citronelle area until integration in 1968. The school, which originally served grades 1 through 12, was founded by local educator and humanitarian Rosa Amelia Lott, 1903 through 1952. Lott wanted to provide the black children of Citronelle and surrounding areas with access to a high school curriculum. Prior to its construction, students desiring to continue their education beyond the seventh grade had to attend school in Mobile or other parts of Alabama. In 1957, it was renamed Rosa A. Lott High School in honor of its founder. It served as a high school until 1969, when it was converted to an elementary school. In 2001, it became a middle school servicing a diverse student population. Before founding the Citronelle Consolidated School, Ms. Lott taught at the Vineland Rosenwald School circa 1921, which stood approximately 500 feet from this site. Vineland School was one of the 389 built in Alabama with assistance from a fund established by prominent educator Booker T. Washington and Sears and Roebuck businessman and philanthropist Julius Rosenwald. Marker erected by Rosa A. Lott Historic Preservation Society Incorporated with support from the Mobile County Public Schools.
Wait. Wait a minute. We have a plaque we would like that to be read too.
In grateful acknowledgement of a grant received from Gulf Coast Resource Conservation and Development Council, Rosa A. Lott Unveiling Ceremony, May 18th, 2013.
The way you're going to be mean.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
This is a great day. And I know that this is the product of a work amid lots of discouragement sometimes for people who just put their shoulders to the grindstone and they just had a vision and they've worked and they've gotten this far. And I know that that group is not finished yet. So let's applaud them for thus far. Yeah, I'm up here as County Commission, represent District 1, but I actually started first grade in that building in Ms. Shepherd's room. She had the first and second grade in the same room together. And I came up here because my mother was teaching over on the other side, home economics. So this is not just a political appearance to me, this is a homecoming. And I'm just grateful that the County Commission has made me play a small part in helping the Rosa A. Lott Historical Society move toward its eventual goal of saving this building. So I know that this is not the last time that they will be calling us together. And let us always remember that when they call, that we should answer, because when we need them, they are always here. All the people you saw line up here, they're the usual suspects. They're supporting everything everybody else does, and now they need some help. And so we need to step up on their behalf. Thank you so much for having me.
Speak up. Come on with
it. Joanne Chastain, first vice president.
Okay, speak up because they talk.
Vincent King,
Green,
second vice president.
Okay.
Loretta Ward, historian of the society.
All right, next. Come on with that mic.
Deborah Darrington, board member.
All right.
Leon Robinson, member.
Okay.
Thank you. Leon Robinson, treasurer.
I guess we'll go on with it. Come on, man.
Jerome Wall, treasurer.
Okay.
Mark, board member.
Okay. Nine.
Chris Wilson, assistant secretary.
Okay. Who next?
Leon Robinson, treasurer.
Okay. Who next? Who next?
Lynette Black, member.
Okay. Okay. Jazz and Red Talk Show, and I finally got a chance where I can get some of these officials. What's your name there, young man?
I'm Mayor of Citronelle.
And what are you?
Mayor of Citronelle.
Mayor of Citronelle, all right. All right, next, who we got? Miss Luck, come on with me.
Mercy Lugger, president of Baldwin County Commission. I represent this district.
Oh, all right, who we got there, young man?
I'm Chad Fincher, state representative of District 102, and proud to represent Citronelle.
All right, who we got here?
I'm Carl Simpson, and I am Washington County Commissioner, District 4.
And you're a Buffalo Soldier, ain't you?
Yes, and I'm a Buffalo Soldier, and I'm also a member of the Mobile Community Act.
All right, who we got there next? Come on with it, young man. What's your name?
My name is Tom Coffey.
Okay.
I teach architectural history at Tuskegee University. And I did the architectural illustration for the Rosa Lott School.
All right, Jazz Red, please. Jazz Red Talk Show, and we're here with Rosa A. Lott family. What's your name now, ma'am?
My name is Alfred Roberts, and Rosa Lott was my great aunt, and I was LPN for 51 years.
51 years of LPN.
Yes, still on us going to.
Golly, all right, who we got next to you there?
I'm a great niece of Rosa A. Lott, and my name is Alvina Sims Kennedy, and I'm a teacher of 36 years.
Teacher of 36 years. That's what I try to inspire them kids to do something on my show, Jazz Red, peace out. Jazz Red Talk Show, what's your name, young man?
My name is Rob.
What you do?
Served
first softball. Okay, you was the what? Okay, the first softball tournament, you was the coach? All right, Jazz Red, peace out. Jazz Red Talk Show, we're going to show you what the school looks like. Everybody's out here for this lady right here. Jazz Red, we love you, peace out. Okay, go ahead.
Hello, I'm Dr. Grace Wyatt. I composed the poem entitled For Rosa A. Lott. I'm a very dear friend of Roslyn Collins.
You're a very dear friend of Roslyn Collins. That was a beautiful poem.
Thank you so much.
Peace out. Red Talk Show, and we got some handsome gentlemen here. We call them important dignitaries. Everybody's a dignitary on Jazz and Red Show. What's your name, young man?
I'm Vernell Gable.
Vernell Gable. What's yours?
Frank Hammond.
Now I was telling this man, I said, now, y'all dress kind of nice. I said, what y'all, a preacher, a deacon? Tell him what you do, Mr. Frank.
I'm actually a tenor and alto saxophone player for the Word of Life Community Church.
Okay, all right. And this man here was a businessman?
Yeah, I'm a former chemical plant worker, and I'm retired. And I used to be a DJ.
Used to be a DJ, a little bit of everything.
A little bit of everything.
Nice seeing you again. You look good. So you've done some good things. God in hell, you up, young man. You hear me? Yes, sir. And well, tell my viewers your was that Mary, your cousin?
Mary Hawkins.
Yeah. Mary Hawkins was my good friend, and that was his kin people. And she gone on to glory now. But Mary, we remembering you today. Okay, that was my friend. I want God to bless you all. Y'all keep doing what you're doing because you're looking good. Family men trying to handle your business. All right, tell them God bless you.
God bless you.
All right, we're up here at Rosa A. Lott. Rosa A. Lott School, we're here. And then we're going in the gymnasium. I just wanted y'all to look at what they're trying to hold. They just trying to keep it, Lord. And everybody's come up here, it was so packed, it was so nice. And that lady Rosa Carter worked very hard now. Now we're going in the gymnasium of this is the old school here. Jazz and Red. We love you, peace out. Jazz and Red Talk Show. We're in the gymnasium. Sure. Red Talk Show, and here we are again with Brother Knapp. What's the word, Brother Knapp?
Amen. Well, today I would like to encourage your heart today out there in TV land. God, just know that God is a Jesus, a God that we can always count on and depend on. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad therein. I just want to let you know we have a real adversary that trying to come against us every which way but how. But Jesus said, in this world, we will have tribulation. We're going to be tested. We're going to go through trial, and we're going to be tempted. But he said, be of a good cheer. So I want you to know to be of a good cheer. No matter life's storm or no matter what life bring at you, remember, be of a good cheer. And this is Brother Knapp bringing you an inspirational moment. And I can be reached at 251-281-6667, and you be blessed.
Jezreel Talk. When I tell this man, Jezreel Talk Show, when I tell this man hit a smile, he'll hit one and laugh. All right, what you got today there,
buddy? Oh, we're talking about socks.
Socks?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, what kind of socks you got there? Hold them up.
Well, they're usually called support holes.
Hold them up, okay.
Support holes.
Support holes.
But now they're called compression. Now they change the name of things.
Okay.
They're made for men and women now. All my men that go out there and buy them gaiters and tennis shoes, they need to buy some nice socks.
Buy some nice socks?
Mm-hmm.
Now, what's the difference between just some cheap socks and old socks?
They don't support your circulation system.
Are you kidding?
Mm-hmm. People that are diabetic or borderline diabetic, they need these support socks to help circulate their blood. Your body circulates 2,000 gallons of blood a day. And your body needs to circulate.
Need to circulate. So they just hold them up again. I'm gonna just zoom in. Yeah. They kind of stretchable.
Yeah, they're stretchable.
So they need support
socket.
And they come in all colors?
All colors.
They come in all colors. But they're support.
They help you with your swollen ankles, sore feet. Yeah. Especially a diabetic, you need to wear them because it circulates your body. See, when you have diabetic, what a diabetic has is a lot of plaque in their blood. And their blood slowly circulate. This helps it.
The socks help circulate the blood?
Through your feet, yeah. Because see, that way your smaller veins are in your feet. So the blood don't circulate as fast. With this, will help it circulate faster.
It'll help it circulate faster.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Are they very high?
No. You can buy any drugstore. Any drugstore, they sell them.
Mm-hmm. Any drugstore get support socks.
Mm-hmm. They call them compression socks.
What they're called?
Compression.
Compression socks.
Mm-hmm. We used to call them support.
Yeah,
they look like this.
Yeah.
They come in brown, black, and different colors.
They're support socks.
Mm-hmm.
And they can be, well, what about if you don't have, if you're not a diabetic?
Oh, you feel a difference.
You feel a difference. You feel a difference.
Your feet won't be as sore. Your ankles won't swell.
That's somebody trying to get us. Keep talking.
Oh, yeah. I've been wearing them for years. My father, he still wear a pair.
Okay, your father's still wearing them.
Mm-hmm. He didn't want to turn me on, too. He told me you need to start wearing them. You know, I'm not a diabetic, but he said anybody that's been on their feet a lot,
yeah,
to wear them. I suppose those are two socks, which you get from the flea market.
Yeah.
Five pair for a dollar? No.
You kidding, man. That sounds like jazz with the cheap socks, you know. But I bought it, that gelling stuff to put it about my shoe. But I see I need some support socks. Well, Jazzy have learned something today. And I hope my viewers have learned something. All right. So now, give them your address. Give them your
3462 Spring Hill Avenue, Suite C. Telephone number, area code 251-610-7117. Area code 251-610-7117.
Now, I want you, for my new viewers, this man do laser weight loss.
And stop smoking.
And stop you from smoking. Now, all you smokers, y'all know y'all got to come off them cigarettes, man. We got people that say, I didn't know they'd make you this sick later on. And they can get a free carbon monoxide test, right?
Definitely.
So at least call for the free carbon monoxide test once he tell you if you're on a high and a low. Maybe that'll make you get off them. Y'all know they no good. They're addictive and they're sick and they're making people sick. I seen a little girl in the hospital and she was young. Mm-hmm. She had lung problems. from cigarettes. So they act like they adding something in on our so-called naturally delicious. Back in the 60s, they would say naturally delicious. And everybody thought that was fashionable in the 60s, the whole cigarette.
Those electric cigarettes, that's a lot of people going to those. And those are dangerous. They will explode in your face.
A lady told me, oh, no, they won't. I said, keep smoking them. I said, stand over there. Get over there with that cigarette, okay?
They will explode.
Yeah, they don't. I've seen that. What we do, ladies and gentlemen, we just put the information out there for you. We're not saying, oh, you can do this or you stupid. We put it out there for you. Then they call me and tell me we were right, though. You know. So we're not putting anything out that's going to hurt you. We're trying to help you. All right, let's get that off. Phone number again.
Okay, area code 251-610-7117.
Okay, and he's on Spring Hill by the Waffle House. That's not very far. Give him the address again.
3462 Spring Hill Avenue, Suite C.
How your wife?
She's fine.
No, I know he's going to go to laughing. All right, I got to get that out of him. All right, tell Gail we say hello.
All right.
All right, then thank you for my breakfast sandwich. I sure needed it. Jazzy Red this morning before I turn the show in. Peace out. All right, I'm going to leave this camera on Thayer's while I read this, because Thayer's, y'all know him. Y'all been asking me about him. He be busy. He going to tell you what he been doing. Universal Prayer Center for All People and the Jazzy Red Talk Show, LLC, presents BRAW and Praise Gospel Explosion 2013. This is something Jazzy is sponsoring. Now, we have given this. All right, Universal Prayer. Y'all know that's Pastor Buckley. All right. All right, it's going to be June 1st at 5:30. That's that Saturday. And 2nd, and June 2nd. June 1st and 2nd is going to be at 5:30 on June 2nd. 5:30 at June 1st, and on the 2nd, it'll be at 3 o'clock. We got Many Afflictions is going to be there. Y'all know Many Afflictions. Y'all know him. He's done a lot of great things. He's a rapper. Many Afflictions is going to be there June 1st and June 2nd. It's going to be at the Holy Church of God Incorporated, 601 South Cedar Street, Mobile, Alabama. For more information, and Jazzy got to go back for more information, you're going to call 251-379-9759 and or 251-442-4342. That is passing across the screen. Now, Jazz is giving this. I'm going to look for y'all to come out. Me, Universal Prayer Center and for All People, Pastor Bradley and Jazzy Red Talk Show. All right? We're presenting BRAW Pray. All right, get those phone numbers out. All right. Now, we've got this young man. Y'all can bite him, young people, because they've been calling for you there. But now, we got to tell them what you've been doing. What you've been doing?
Oh, man, I've been by my father's being the Jazzy Red. You know, a lot of people talk the talk, but you got to get out there and walk the walk. You know, I've been in the community, Jazzy Red, just working with city officials, the mayor, Pritchard, Troy Eveman.
Yeah.
And, you know, just trying to get the community together. And we got to start with the churches, you know. A lot of our churches just out there doing an individual thing. And I'm not speaking for all, I'm just speaking in general, but it's time for the whole community to come together.
It really is.
And our people come to the churches for healing, but, you know, everybody just staying in the walls of their own building and not really just getting out in the community. And if they do get in the community, you know, everybody doing their own thing and doing their own agenda. So we got to come together for one cause, you know.
That's
and
right.
That's all the churches, don't matter the denomination, it don't matter how big the church is. You know, we losing our sheep.
We sure are.
You know, and Christ said, woe to the shepherds that lead our sheep astray. So we got to go out there and get our sheep, and our sheep is our young folk.
That's right.
It's our kids.
That's right.
We got to get out in the community. We got to reach out. And they got so much talent, but we're not offering any refuge. We got to let them know that churches is a safe place to go. A lot of people think just because you go to church, young people think because you go to church, you lame or something like that. We got to let them know, man, you still going to be cool. You still going to be hip. You still can be yourself.
Sure can.
And still get an opportunity.
And one thing about them reverends, I've seen them reverends go to court with some of them young folk, man.
Yes, sir.
And speak up for them young folk.
Yes, sir.
Now, some of them reverends, not all of them, but I've seen some of them reverends take time out of their busy schedule to go to court with them kids, man, to speak up for them kids. And that's what I'm talking about.
So, you know, that's what I've been doing out here, trying to come up with a program or come up with an event to allow kids to utilize their talent and try to make this an annual thing. For the city of Pritchard. They say, what good can come out of Nazareth? What good can come out of the city of Pritchard? you know, the media give us so much negative publicity to where it's some positive things going on.
Oh, y'all got a lot of stuff, man.
No doubt.
The Africa Town. And then y'all got a lot of festivities. Y'all give concerts and stuff. You got concerts coming up. So Pritchard has picked up a whole lot.
And that don't get covered. So we just want to let the world know, man, some positive things. We got some positive people that live in the city, some great citizens, man. You know, don't believe everything you read, man, no doubt, Jazz.
I'm telling you, and like I say, there are some reverends that are going to go and help you.
No doubt, and they're reaching out, Jazz and Red.
Yeah, they are.
You know, when I knock on the door open, man, they're reaching out and everybody jumping on board and everybody, you know, want to see something, you know, happen in the direction that we're trying to go in.
Okay, all right. But before you say word for the day, I thank you for telling them that. I want to say hello to Thomas Richardson. He works for the city of Mobile. Thomas Richardson. I hope I said that right, Mr. Thomas. You told me you watch my show every Saturday. You say you don't miss it. You say you went to Lou Castle to eat because of that. You and all your work buddies, we're going to say hello to you all. All right, all the people that work at the city of Mobile. Now give them word for the day there.
Word for the day, Jazz and Red. The race isn't for the swift. It's for the ones who endure. And success is a marathon, not a race. And I'm talking to my young people. We want instant success. But you got to hold on, man. You got to learn how to endure. Things just don't happen overnight. Let me give you a little story. It was a wolf chasing after a rabbit. And he was right on that rabbit tail, and the rabbit been running for almost 2 miles, but he was kind of slowing down, but he kept pushing. And every now and then that wolf would snap at his tail and just almost get his tail, Jazz and Red.
Okay.
But he kept pushing, he kept running, till he passed by a frog standing on the ledge. And the frog said, Mr. Rabbit, is you gonna make it? The rabbit looked over at the frog while he was running and said, I got to make it.
That's right.
That means if he would have stopped and he would have slowed down, that would have been him. He would have been grass. He would have been eaten up.
That's right.
So young people, we can't stop.
That's
no
right.
matter what your dream is, it won't happen overnight because God did not create the world overnight. And I think that God could have took one day.
Yeah,
one day.
It'd be one.
To create the whole world.
That's
he could have
right.
did it in one. But he said he did it in six.
Okay.
He did it in six, and he rested on the seventh. But that was just to let us know that it's a process to no matter what we do.
It is.
So success is a marathon, not a race.
All right. That is a word from the David Thayer. Thayer, I'm going to appreciate you. Thayer just got through cutting my grass. Y'all know how my yard look, right?
Grinding, cutting grass.
Yeah.
Coaching basketball. God just blessed me with a new position at the YMCA. Be assistant director over the summer camp.
The summer camp.
Yeah.
That's all right.
That's a blessing, man.
It really is. It's something you like doing.
Yeah.
So,
being
you know,
kids, working with young folks.
Working with the young folks. Yeah. That's what you like doing. And you like doing that.
God got my steps already on.
He got it coming on.
Yeah.
See that? You just got to get up and do something. Sitting there at home on the couch. Sit at home on the couch and watch Jazz Red Show. But Monday morning, like a chicken, get up. Get up with the chicken.
No
Jazz
problem.
Red.
Peace out.
All right. Jazz and Red Talk Show, and we up here at Memorial Funeral Home, serving all policies. The owner is Bishop Cornelius Woods, and here's the phone number, 251-457-6440. Come out and let him handle your business for you. Just a good friend of mine, Bishop Cornelius Woods. Memorial Funeral Home, Jazz and Red. Let me show you what it looks like. God bless you all. God bless all of y'all. That Jazz old school truck. Y'all come out and let Bishop Woods handle you, okay? Been knowing him a long time. This man helped a lot of people. Hey, all right, let me give you that phone number again, 251-457-6440. We love you, Bishop Woods. Jazz Red, peace out.
I started playing guitar at 64 years old. Now, June the 3rd, I'll be 80 years old. And I thank God for that. Yeah. If I never see another day, I thank God for what he has done for me. for this education that try to help the young people. And what the, you know, when the young people see you do something, don't think they ain't watching. They see you, and they know what you're doing, and sooner or later you try to stop them, they will tell you you did it. So you be careful what you're doing in front of the church. Be careful.
Thank you. to break every chain, to break every chain, to break every chain. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, to break every chain, to break every chain. On the
I say thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
I say thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
And I